You like my watermelon shirt? Hey plant friends, and welcome back to my channel, Planta by Gia, the nutrition kitchen. I am so sorry because I haven't been around for about 2 weeks, but I just got back from the most amazing trip me and my husband went on. We went to Mexico. To two different places in Mexico. For the first 4 days, we went to a town called Tulum, and then the last 4 days, we went to Cancun. I brought my camera around with me because I wanted to show you guys, put together a little vlog of our trip. But before we get into the video, I wanted to tell you a little bit about the food and all the choices that, plant-based choices that I was able to find. Tulum was my absolute favorite place. It was so beautiful, guys. So Tulum is like, there's Tulum town and then there's Tulum beach. Me and my husband found a beautiful, cute little private villa in Tulum town. Now Tulum town is very authentic, a lot of authentic Mexican places, and then Tulum beach. Tulum beach is more touristy, there's a lot more hotels, but it is so beautiful and it's a very health forward town. So there's a lot of vegans, there's a lot of vegan options, a lot of vegan restaurants. There's gyms right on the beach. There's also yoga places literally at every single hotel and spa. Also in, so we rented a motorbike and we drove all around. We were able to see all the different places. We went to this thing called Los Cenotes, which is like a cave underground with water. You can swim around, you can snorkel. There's bats that fly back and forth because they live under there. It is literally one of the most beautiful things I've ever seen. So yeah, so back into the food. It had amazing options for me, plant-based options. There was, like I said, all different vegan restaurants, but over there I had a lot of acai bowls, a lot of fresh juices for breakfast, like guava juice, they had papaya juice, coconut yogurt parfaits. There was even this cute little market called the Gypsy Market, and it was the most freshest. They had so many different plant-based options. It was so clean, it was beautiful. And then for lunch over there, there were so many different vegan options. I was able to find like vegan enchiladas, all different vegan tacos. I don't know how they made it down there, but they had El Pastor tacos, and they also had vegan steak tacos, and those were so, so, so good. So yeah, so I had a lot of different options in Tulum. We even went to Pablo Escobar's mansion and had dinner there, and he had some options, some vegan options on there as well. And so we stayed there for 4 days. That was the best time ever. And then we traveled over to a resort called Vedanta, and the resort was in Cancun. Talking so much, I'm getting, it's hot out here, right, Daisy? So at Vedanta was more of an all-inclusive resort. It was so beautiful. The whole resort was filled with these huge pools that just went all around. It was gorgeous. The only thing was, at the resort, since COVID was going on, there wasn't too many options. They had to close, like, and they were only open down to like 30% of the what they usually have. So we only had to choose from a couple places. In the morning, they had this beautiful buffet. The thing that I really liked about this resort, actually, is they're very sustainable. They grew their own fruits and vegetables, and they recycled their water. So I gotta give them that. That was amazing. At the pool, when we would hang out a lot, there wasn't too many plant-based vegan options there. I ate a lot of guacamole. It was the best guacamole I've ever had, and it was always an option. I liked Tulum a little bit better because we were able to like go into the town and see the actual culture and the real life of Mexico, as opposed to going to like a resort where it's kind of just, you're on the resort and you don't really go outside of it. You barely could even tell you were in Mexico. But I'm very grateful for the entire trip. We had so much fun. So So I took my camera around as much as I could. I was having so much fun that I forgot it a lot. But I put together this little vlog for you so you can see all the food that we ate and a couple places that we went to. I hope that you love it. So without further ado.
Yeah, day before going to Tulum.
Looking like a red tomato.
Yeah, looking like a red tomato. Packing. Got the doggies. Ready.
Some vegan al pastor and some vegan beefy vegan steak. Ooh. Hi! Say hi, baby.
Hi.
Vegan enchiladas in a salsa verde. Delicious. Both are literally making me drool. But we have some vegan tacos in here. It's like a vegan textured soy protein. Beautiful beet salad. This is from El Vegetariano in Tulum, Mexico. Delicious. Marido amor. Mm-hmm.
Hey friends, so we've moved places. Now we're not in Tulum anymore. Now we are in a resort in Cancun. To take you along with me today and show you all the plant-based foods that I'm gonna be eating in refried beans, peppers and onions, some habanero sauce, some chopped cilantro, onions, chilaquiles, verde, vegan, platanos, some hash browns, look at this fresh jelly, passion fruit, and strawberry. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it and subscribe to my channel for more plant-based weekly recipes. You can also find me on Instagram at Planta by Gia, where I'm always posting my daily cooking. And yeah, I love you guys so much. Thank you for watching and I will see you for the next recipe. Friends, and welcome back to my channel, Planta by Gia, the nutrition kitchen. Today I'm going to the beach, but before I do, I wanted to bring you guys into my kitchen and share with you some of my favorite recipes to bring to the beach. When you're at the beach, it's hot, so that's why it's nice to have light and all different types of snacks to pick on. I like to bring sweet and savory types of snacks because you never know what mood you're going to be in. I'm also going to be making a fresh orange strawberry juice to bring so that we can mix it in with some Prosecco or make some fresh margaritas. I'm not the biggest drinker. Fun fact, I actually used to be a bartender for many, many years before I fell in love with the healthy life. Now, I don't drink too often, but when I do, I love to sip on some nice fresh juice and celebrate love and life. So before I share with you what's on the menu, go ahead and smash that like button for me and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for weekly plant-based recipes and nutrition tips. The first thing on the menu is a fresh fruit salad with chopped watermelon, strawberries, and some fresh mint from the garden.
Watermelon is one of my favorite snacks to bring to the beach because it's so hydrating and delicious. It's also extremely refreshing. The mint also gives it a refreshing, cool kick to it, which is so nice. The next thing we're bringing is a side of cherries because cherries are so much fun to bring to the beach. They're so easy to eat and they're extremely delicious. Cherries are great for balancing out the body's pH system and also helping you get a great night's sleep because they actually contain high amounts of melatonin in them. So they're a great natural melatonin supplement. Next on the menu is fresh guacamole, and not just any guacamole. We're gonna top this guacamole with a fresh corn cilantro lime salad, and we're gonna serve it with some blue corn tortilla chips to dip right in. The fourth thing on the menu is a nice cold pasta salad. We're gonna put the pasta salad with some chopped peppers, onions, black olives, and a nice vinaigrette dressing on top. And last but not least is falafel pita pockets. So we're gonna make some homemade falafel and stuff them in pita pockets and make a plant-based vegan tzatziki sauce to drizzle on top. I'm so excited. My mouth is already drooling. So when you're going to prepare a bunch of different things like this, it's very important to look at all your instructions for all of your recipes and figure out which recipe takes the longest so that you can start with that first, and in between you can do the others so that you can finish all at the same time. Everything on this menu is pretty simple. The only things that require cooking is the falafel and the pasta. So the first thing we're going to do is make the falafel mix because that needs to cool and set for about 20 minutes. So we'll go and do that while we do the other things. The next thing that we're going to do is cook the pasta, and the other step will be shaving the cucumber down so that we can keep the shavings on top and we can drain the juice because it needs to be dry when we put the shaved cucumbers into the tzatziki sauce. Okay, so let's go get to cooking because this girl needs a nice tan and some good food in her belly. To begin, we want to shave the cucumbers on a cheese grater. I am straining it over a cheesecloth contraption, but you can also strain it on a ladle or any type of strainer that you have in your kitchen. We're gonna let that set aside and drain. Then we're going to add the water to the pasta pot and get that on the stove to boil while we clean our cherries and jalapenos. Next up is the falafel mix. So we're going to be needing 2 cans of chickpeas. We're going to drain the water from the chickpea and add it into a food processor. Then chop up about 1/2 of a red onion, thinly sliced. And unpeel about 5 cloves of garlic and add that into the food processor. Next, we want to add the spices to the food processor. So we're going to put about 1 teaspoon of cumin, about 1 to 2 teaspoons of chili powder, some garlic powder, and salt and pepper to taste.
Then we're going to blend on high until it's about a paste-like consistency. But in the middle, I'm going to open up the food processor and add in my fresh parsley and cilantro. Close it back up and blend it again back up to a nice paste. Then we're going to make little spoonfuls of them, scoop them out, and place them on parchment paper, and then put them in the refrigerator and let them cool and set for about 20 minutes. It's time for the guacamole. So I'm using about 4 to 5 avocados for this recipe because I'm going to make a pretty big serving. I also like to get the avocados very ripe so that they're perfect and ready to go when I need them. To know if the avocado is ready for the guacamole, when you press it, there should be a little indent from your finger and you know that it's ripe. I then use about 1/4 cup of red onion and I chop that roughly. And then I chopped up about 1/4 cup of tomato, nicely diced, to add that into the guacamole. Then the water started to boil, so I added my pasta. Add the red onion and tomatoes to the bowl. And let's get to mashing, baby! About a pinch of Himalayan salt or sea salt and a pinch of garlic, all of this to taste. We're going to add some chopped fresh cilantro. And a squeeze of some fresh lime. And you don't want to over mash it, just enough so you get chunks and still full pieces of the avocado. And to make that corn salsa, we're gonna start off by cutting up some cherry tomatoes, quartering them or halving them and adding them into the bowl. Adding about 1 cup of sweet corn, canned or fresh, and chopping up some fresh jalapeno, deseeding it so it's not as spicy. Adding everything into the bowl with some chopped cilantro. Squeezing some fresh lime on top. Salt and pepper to taste, as well as a little bit of garlic salt. Mixing it around nicely. And adding that beautiful thing on top of our guacamole. Thank you. Next up is the cold pasta salad. So we are going to chop up about a half of a green pepper and half of a red pepper as well. Slicing some black olives to add into the bowl. Black olives are my absolute favorite thing in this entire world. And slicing thinly some red onion. Now the dressing is going to be using some balsamic vinegar, a little bit of olive oil, about a tablespoon of Dijon mustard, some garlic, salt and pepper to taste, a little bit of oregano, and some fresh lemon juice. And the actual full recipe will be linked down below for you to follow if needed. Time to pack those fresh cherries. And chop up some fresh watermelon and strawberries for our beautiful watermelon strawberry fruit mint salad. Homemade plant-based vegan tzatziki sauce. So I'm going to put about 1 cup of vegan sour cream. This brand is from Follow Your Heart. It's amazing. I'm chopping up about 2 tablespoons of fresh dill. And adding about 1/2 of a lemon freshly squeezed. Then you want to squeeze out the rest of the liquid from the cucumber that's been draining and add those grated slices into the tzatziki sauce with some salt and pepper to taste and mix it around nicely. Last but not least, we want to put a little bit of olive oil into a pan and get our cooled set falafel mix into the pan to crisp up and turn into a nice falafel. I'm going to pack my pita pocket with the falafels, some chopped cucumber, red onion, and some diced cherry tomatoes. And at the beach, I will drizzle on the tzatziki sauce. Then we're going to make the strawberry orange juice. So I'm slicing up some oranges. You don't need to slice every type of fruit when you juice, but citrus fruits, it's really important to skin them so that you don't get that bitter taste. My absolute favorite juicer from Revel, and I will link it down in the description for you. All right, let's pack it up and go.
Thank you.
definitely try out these snacks next time you go to the beach. You can find me on Instagram at Planta by Gia, and you can find me on my website at www.plantabygia.com, where I offer nutrition coaching and fitness plans. I love you guys so much. Thank you for watching, and I will see you for the next recipe.
Good morning, Sporty. Good morning, Daisy.
Another episode of Planta by Gia. This is my second to last week of my master's in nutrition program. I actually have a final today at 5, and I have a comprehensive exam, which is like the exit exam, that I'm taking next Wednesday. So we're gonna be doing what I eat in a day as a plant-based nutritionist, as a vegan, and I'm also looking to cut a little bit of body fat, so I have been tracking my macros. I'm not the biggest fan of tracking macros. It tends to be just like kind of like a mind game. I wasn't tracking macros during my whole weight loss journey, but now as I have slimmed down, I'm finding that, yeah, it's very important to track your macros to make sure you are in a calorie deficit to lose a certain percentage of body fat. So, what I eat today are great meals that you can incorporate into your daily life. Oh, also what I've been doing is something called intermittent fasting. I start eating at 12 and I stop eating at 8. It's really helped me to cut back on the snacking, stay within my goals. It is about 12:30 now, so we're behind schedule. I'm starving. I have already worked out. I did a little bit of fasted cardio. I did some yoga. And the first meal is going to be a protein berry berry smoothie. I drank this literally every single day, so let's get to it. Okay, so for this smoothie, this is my favorite plant-based protein company. They are called Vivo Life. I love it because it is made from all whole foods. It has turmeric extract, it has ginger extract, and it's fermented, so it's a lot easier to digest. So I always use this. Today for the morning, we're gonna be using the vanilla. So I use 2 scoops of this. And then we're gonna put in some flaxseed. Flaxseed is to get your daily dose of omega-3s. Then I'm going to be putting in 1 cup of frozen berries. These have blackberries, blueberries, raspberries, and strawberries. I just add 1 cup of spinach. Sometimes I add 1/2 banana, but none of my bananas are ripe, so no bananas. Agora, today. How do you say today in Portuguese? I have no idea. So, 2 scoops of this is 25 grams of protein. That is a lot of protein, and that is a great meal to have. Add 1 cup of frozen berries, 2 tablespoons of flaxseed, and some spinach. Guys, putting spinach into smoothies is the best thing you can do for yourself. It's full of iron. You can't even taste it when it's in there. And I just add some coconut water. It's delicious. I love it because it's also low carb, but it's very high in protein, so it will keep me full for about 1.5 hours. I am going to go study, and then I will see you guys back for my second meal. I usually have about 4 meals a day, so I will see you guys 4 times. Okay guys, so I'm finished studying, and actually
while I was studying, I got a message from my professor canceling my final today, and she rescheduled it for tomorrow, which I'm kind of happy about, but at the same time, I wanted to just get it over with. But whatever, there's nothing I can do. So I just studied a little bit extra and now I'm starving. I'm gonna make something quick this meal. So what I have already is some mashed cauliflower that I made. I just steamed it and then I put it into a food processor with a little bit of almond milk and some garlic. And then I just roasted some potatoes. I'm gonna warm these guys up. Roasted them yesterday. What I'm going to use as my protein is I'm going to take this tempeh. I'm gonna just grill it on a pan. So tempeh is super easy to cook. Literally, you can just put it on a pan. You can even put it in a toaster, but it's basically already cooked, so you just need to heat it up to give it a little crisp. So we are crisping it up on this. Okay, so here is my finished product. We have the roasted potatoes and mashed cauliflower that I made from yesterday, and my crispy grilled tempeh that I'm going to dip in my homemade barbecue sauce. Mashed cauliflower is amazing. It literally tastes just like potatoes. I drink water with everything, about 4 of these a day. Yeah, water's great for you. And you should drink your water. Okay, so I got the string beans in a cast iron grill and I put in my vegan chicken with some onions and garlic and ginger. I also added some soy sauce and I'm gonna add some little bit of rice vinegar. And then over here I got my rice, my steamed jasmine rice. Okay, so this is the final project. We have half a cup of steamed rice. I cooked the green beans a little extra because I like them extra cooked. And the chicken looks insane. I topped it with some sesame seeds and purple basil from my garden. And I wanted to show you, this is what I made for my husband. I made him this really cool Japanese fried rice from Trader Joe's that we get with these vegetable wontons and the string beans on top. So his meal is a little more extra calories than mine, and that's how it usually goes. So let's eat because I am hungry. And they're nice and crunchy. I forgot. I bought this hot sauce online and it's from China because there's no English on it except for the word hot. But I am going to put it on top. It's really hot, look at it. It's like a hot sauce jelly type thing. Oh, okay, that's hot. Oh. Papaya. I emptied out the seeds and I put a vegan dairy-free coconut yogurt in the middle. Then I added some hemp seeds for protein, chia seeds for calcium and protein. We added some almond butter granola, delicious, with some chopped strawberries and a drizzle of peanut butter. Guys, this is delicious. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. If you enjoyed this video, if you loved my meals, please give me a big thumbs up. I love you guys so much. Thank you for tuning in. Wish me luck on tomorrow's test. And I will see you guys next week for a surprise recipe.
What do we look like, little babies?
Hey plant friends, and welcome back for another episode of Welcome back for another episode of Planta by Gia. Warm weather is upon us, so today I'm going to bless you with a delicious, flavorful recipe that's high in protein to keep you full, low in carbohydrates, and also low in calories to keep you slim. Today's dish is called eggplant rollatini, and this is a very special dish to me because it is an Italian dish. And guess what? I am Italiana. My full name is actually Giovanna. So growing up, I grew up on a bunch of Italian dishes, and I was kind of sad when I switched to plant-based because I thought that I wouldn't be able to eat these dishes again. But later did I find out that I can still have every single dish just made without animal products. So this dish is actually called eggplant rollatini because what you do is you literally roll the eggplant in ricotta cheese. So we obviously are not going to be using any dairy in this kitchen, and we are going to be making the ricotta cheese with tofu. But before I get into the recipe, I wanted to talk to you about why vegans and people who eat whole food plant-based do not consume dairy. So actually, 70% of humans are lactose intolerant. What this means is that their bodies cannot properly break down lactose, which is in dairy. And this can cause nausea, belly cramps and pain, bloating, gas. Dairy is also considered an inflammatory food because it's loaded in saturated fats. And it's also one of the main causes of acne in people. I used to have a lot of acne, and just by cutting out dairy, I saw a dramatic change in my skin complexion. Okay, so let's get into the recipe. So this recipe is going to be separated into three parts. The first is a homemade marinara sauce. And we're going to do this first because we want to get it on the stove and let it simmer for about an hour. So what we're going to be needing for the homemade marinara sauce is 1 can of crushed tomatoes, 1 can of tomato paste. Then we're going to mince about 4 to 5 cloves of garlic and use about 1 to 2 tablespoons of olive oil. All right, so let's go get it on the stove. Okay, so we're gonna let the marinara sauce sit on the stove and simmer on a low heat for about an hour. We're going to be needing 2 large eggplants. I found the biggest eggplants I could find. They literally look like little babies. So we're gonna need 2 large eggplants. We're gonna rinse them off, and then what we're going to be doing is slicing them long ways. After that, we're going to be putting some salt on top of them, just a sprinkle of salt, and letting them sit in a colander, because what the salt does, it is absorbs all the liquid and it also takes the bitterness out of the eggplant. So let's get to slicing. Now you want to slice them about 1/4 inch thick so that it's easy to roll them. So first you want to cut off the sides. We're not going to use that part. And then you're just going to slice up your knife right to the edge. Just like that.
actually like to use Himalayan salt rather than table salt, because Himalayan salt is filled with minerals and it's much less processed than regular salt. Okay, so as we let the eggplant sit and soak out all of the water, we're gonna let it sit for about 15 minutes. We're now going to be making the tofu ricotta. So this dish is a high protein dish, and that is because tofu is very high in plant proteins. It's also a great source of plant-based calcium as well as iron. So to make the tofu ricotta, we're going to put it in a food processor with 1 to 2 tablespoons of fresh lemon, 2 tablespoons of nutritional yeast. Nutritional yeast is super healthy for you. It even has some vitamin B12 in it as well. 1 teaspoon of apple cider vinegar, 1/2 cup of fresh basil. I actually went into my garden earlier before and picked these. And some salt and pepper to taste. We're going to put it in the food processor and grind it up. If it gets a little too thick, you can always add a little bit of almond milk, but I suggest just going 1 tablespoon at a time because you don't want it to get too smooth. We want it to be nice and fluffy, like a ricotta cheese. Also, don't forget to check on your marinara sauce. Just give it a little spin and see how it's doing. The kitchen smells beautiful right now. I wish you could smell it. Okay, so now if you see it's a little blocky, we want to get it a little more smooth, so I'm going to add about 1 tablespoon of almond milk. You can use any type of plant milk you'd like, and I'm then going to be putting in the basil last to chop it up to give it a little grit. That is about the consistency that we're looking for. Just like a ricotta cheese. So now since the eggplant has been sitting for about 15 minutes and sweated out a lot, if you feel it now, you can actually see all the water dripping off of it. So now we're just gonna pop it into the oven at 425 for about 15 minutes, and this is gonna soften up the eggplant and make it easier for us to roll. So what you're gonna need is some olive oil or coconut oil. And what you're gonna do is you're just going to spray each side of the eggplant and you're gonna line them up on a baking sheet. Now we're gonna roll it up. So the first thing that we're gonna do is we're going to spoon the sauce into the bottom of the pan. Then we're going to take each eggplant and we're gonna put about 1 tablespoon of ricotta into each eggplant, and we're gonna roll the eggplant up and place it right on top of the sauce. Then we're gonna line it up nicely and add some more sauce on top. Thank you. Now I'm just going to add a few extra spices. These are at your own. You can put as much as you want. I'm just going to sprinkle a little bit of basil and some oregano. Also some red pepper, because I love a little spice. Okay, so now we're gonna take this and we're gonna put it back into the oven at 400 and bake for another 10 minutes, and then we are done. Is also very versatile. You could put it with a side salad, or you could also make some pasta on the side to make it a little bit more higher carb, high calorie meal. I love this dish so much. The ricotta cheese gives it such a depth of flavor, and every bite is just full of richness and scrumptiousness. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like it if you did. Comment down below what you liked best. Let me know other recipes that you would like me to make. You can find me on Instagram at plantabygia, and you can also find me on my website at plantabygia.com, where I offer nutrition coaching and fitness plans. Thank you so much for watching. I love you guys so much, and I will see you for the next recipe.
Hi. This is Ray Negron from Reach Out with Ray and Steve. And this is our special guest, Avani. And Avani is learning about H2O1 hand sanitizers. This is the sanitizer Gio Urshela and Gleb Artura sent to Venezuela, Colombia, and a little country called the Bronx. But anyway, let's try this. Okay. Okay, now spray it all over. Smell it?
It smells good.
Woo! That's what I'm talking about. Tell everybody.
It smells good.
H2O1 hand sanitizer on Reach Out with Ray and Steve, right?
Yes.
How's it going? My name is Hector.
Hector, you're from the Bronx.
Yes, that's correct. Bronx, New York.
And what we got here?
We have a galore of food thanks to Ray and the amazing organization.
Well, you know, thanks to everybody that's supporting. Thank you, Yankees and
absolutely.
Yankee organization. Thank you, Steve, Long Island Cares, because you ran out of food, and that's
yes.
What, where?
911 Longwood Avenue, located in the Bronx.
Okay, you ran out of food, and there are lines of people over there.
Yes, right around the corner.
So if you do have more food, to bring it over to
the Bronx Food Pantry, located at 911 Longwood Avenue in the Bronx.
Please take care of the people over there. We don't need, people are literally hungry over there.
Yes, yes.
Okay, well, we'll do what we got to do. Thank you, thank you.
Thank you.